Now, this king, instead of you coming before him, he got messengers that he'll send out a word to you. Hello, somebody. But you got to stand before his gate. Hello, somebody. Huh? All right, now. Then with this little boy and this little girl, I gotta keep your mind open about that big gate now. It was this boy and this little girl, and they were going through different situations. So they got down on their knees at their house before they went to bed. And they were praying, and they said, Lord, I need help. Lord, my rent due. My light bills due. Lord, this and that. So God heard they cry because they wouldn't stop crying. They were like the blind man. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Hello, somebody. So the Lord, this great king, now he heard them crying. One of them was talking about, Lord, I don't know what I done did. What God done see it, I got, Lord. Help me, Lord, I can't get on my feet before I look like I'm spread on. Lord, I can't get nowhere. He instead of crying out to God. Crying out to the king. Now this king is back here. And this is his wall here, big old wall here. And you can't see through that wall. And the king's sitting on his throne. I just tell you what he's doing. He's sitting on his throne, and he answered out. And folks come before him to get their request, their petition. Right. Bringing their petition unto the king. He's sending out petitions. So the king heard the little boy prayer that night, heard the little girl prayer that night. Right. Amen. So the king, and the little boy would cry out, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And the Lord, the king, back there, he said, bring him unto me. Yeah. So he says, angels went out and touched him in the morning. Yeah. Early one morning, it was Sunday morning. Yeah. And grabbed him and brought him in before the gate. Right. And he didn't, it was the king was going to ask him in a certain order. So he had him to sit down inside right by the gate. He sat down right here. And he said, and the king, see, now I want you to picture this. All of a sudden, the door opened.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, somebody.
All right.
And the messenger went into the door, and he got what the great king had left, put into his spirit. And he come back outside of this great door. And he began to prophesy and preach and to tell the world about it, huh? Yeah. Maybe he might laugh. Maybe he might spit. Maybe he might hello somebody. Yeah. Now, there were those out in front of the gate. And then they said, now this is a big gate. This king behind me. I heard Jacob say, this is none other in the house of the living God. It is a fearful place. Hello, somebody. And hello, somebody. David said, I was glad when he said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Since you've been praying all them prayers, crying out, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. The angel stopped by your house this morning and picked you up and brought you before the gate time. See, this gate, that gate, and you got to know how to get through that gate. That gate don't open with open sesame. But if you been born again, yeah, the gate is open, and you go in and out and find pastor. So the messenger, he goes into the gate because he know when he go before the gate, they see the Holy Spirit. He said, in the name of Jesus. And the gate said, come on in. Come on in. He go in and he sat with the Lord, and the Lord sat with him. And he come back out and he began to preach and tell the folks, in the name of Jesus, this thing is spiritual, sir. Not carnal, sir. But the little boy, he don't like the way the messenger laughs. He don't like the way the messenger talks. So his heart is hard. And now he hates the messenger. He hates, I can't stand him. He always prophesies evil. I hate him. And but the messenger had the word. He said, there was this earthly king, and he wasn't living right. And he sent for the messenger of the Lord. He said, is there not in here a messenger of the Lord, a prophet of God? And he called this Michael, and he come out, and he said, well, I don't like him. He always prophesies evil toward me. But now, the king, he's sitting in there to destroy the little boy, because the little boy is the one that got down on his knees and prayed and asked the Lord to do this and asked the Lord to do that. The little girl prayed and asked the Lord to do this and asked the Lord to do that. And because the Lord heard the little boy's prayer and heard the little girl's prayer, he sitting upon his throne, and he called his disciples, and he told his angel, he said, go out and bring such and such into my house. And the messenger come in, and he put in the messenger's spirit what he was supposed to preach or teach that Sunday. But when the messenger preached and taught what the king had put in him, the receiver got angry. I heard a preacher one time say, don't get mad with the mailman. All I'm doing is delivering the mail. Huh? You the one got business with them. You the one praying all them things that you, see, number one, you quit to speak and ask God all kinds of things that you ain't man enough to receive. Hello, somebody. And when God's word comes, let me show you something. It said, but as it is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have entered into the hearts of man the thing which God has prepared for them to love him. Now, if God's word doesn't offend you, hello, somebody, this is the end results of God's word. It said, but as it is written, it says written, it can't be changed. This great king behind this great wall has caused this to be written. And it was called by his Holy Spirit. And because it is written, it is unchangeable. Hello, somebody. And it said, but as it is written, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither have entered into the hearts of man the things which God has prepared for them that love him. But God has revealed them things unto us by his Spirit, for they are spiritually, but God has revealed them things unto us by his Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God. See, the word that came forth from the messenger was the deep things of God. They were spiritual and not carnal, and because you did not have the ability to search out the deep thing, because you was in shallow water, because you can't swim in deep water, because the flesh cannot last in deep water, because the flesh and blood cannot enter into the kingdom of God, and you being carnal and discerning of spiritual things is deceived by sin once again. Hello, somebody. See, because what happened is that first comes sin, then comes love, then comes death. Now, the sting of sin, the sting of death is sin. And the strength of sin is the law. And because you are under the law, As long as you abide in the flesh, I don't care how holy you get. As long as you abide in the flesh, you are under the law. You are under the law. We that are born again are under the Spirit, the grace of God. We the spirits of the discern thing, because that has become on our mentality. That's our wisdom. See, the Bible said, he that would have wisdom, let him ask of God. See, the wisdom of God you can't get from this world. The wisdom of God, the only way you can get the wisdom of God is you have to ask God. But a double-minded man will receive nothing of the law. Your yea have to be yea, your nay have to be nay. You understand what I'm saying? See, because the thing of the spirit of foolishness unto a man. Hello, somebody. Amen. If I tell you to get in the spirit, if I tell you to watch and pray, that's foolishness unto you. Hello, somebody. If I tell you don't answer a thing before you hear to be so quick to answer, that's foolishness unto you. Amen. But to us is the wisdom of God. Hello, somebody. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Ain't got to go far. You just got to study the Bible. In the book of 1 Corinthians, the very first chapter. See, before you get to the second chapter, you got to go through the first chapter. Hello, somebody. It says, in verse 18. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent. Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputers of this world? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of this world? For after that, in wisdom of God, the world by wisdom knew not God. It pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. See, if the preacher's preaching and he's still a God, the Bible said, it pleased God by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. Now, if you don't believe, when the word comes forward, you offended in the word because you don't believe. Let me show you something. When the word of God comes to me, hello somebody, and that word comes, and it cut my throat. Even though it cut my throat, I believe. And because I believe, after that it done cut my throat, the Spirit of God began to show me that it is written, eyes have not seen, neither is the mind able to see the good thing that God has for those that love him. If I love God, look at it, let me show you something. Just said, Scott, you my son. And I'm getting down on you in front of everybody. And you saying, and it hurts you. And you began to discern, why would my daddy get down on me right there? But you love me and you believe in me. And the first thing you said, well, maybe he just want me to be better than anybody else. Maybe he was coming at me to bestow some special blessing on me and not to destroy me, because one thing, I love my father. And I know he loves me. And not only that, I believe in him. And I believe God put him in my life. So I know that God don't destroy. He didn't come to destroy life. He come to save life. Maybe I got a shallow mind because I'm not in the spirit. And since I'm not in the spirit, I can't understand anything he do anyway, because he's spirit.